Is this you? You are a smart person. More than smart, actually. You have distinguished interests in very peculiar subjects. Maybe it's math or an unknown branch of history or philosophy. Maybe you pride yourself in your coding abilities or your bell curve defying results on an arbitrary IQ test. And you kinda hate other people because you are so smart, aren't you? They're just not on the same level with you. How could they be? You think you are special. And yes, you are. We don't do feel-good bullshit around this place. You are quite the hotshot in your particular endeavor. But what you don't realize is that you are king in a petite corner of reality. You can see depth, you can see far, far away into the distance. You are quite dumbfounded on the fact that others can't see what you're seeing. It makes you bitter that you can see through eyes that most couldn't fathom. What you don't yet realize though is that you are wearing horse blinders. You're basically seeing life through a long but narrow lens. Many such cases. Hence why I'm making this video to address this problem. So, the highest priority skill every intelligent person should master is the art of observing without judgment. This is the plague of above average and very high IQ people. But this is usually a bigger problem in the above average intelligence part of the bell curve. Maybe you are familiar with the concept of Elo Hell if you've played 2000 plus hours of competitive shooters. This is Elo Hell, but in real life. You're smart enough to figure out some things that the average person can't, but not smart enough to find out that those things don't give you an edge in general, just in your particular game. It's like a neat toy you've discovered and you want to show all the people around. But still, it is seen as a toy. You're obsessed with your particular toy. To you, it's the best thing on the planet. You are defined by it, and you become judgmental whenever other people don't see the same value. Chances are that you haven't even learned to communicate that value well. But that's another talk for another day. Why did I choose this specific skill of observing without judgment? Sounds quite peculiar, doesn't it? Well, it is because it is a non-superficial money shot skill that flows down from the core into all other parts of your life. This includes the most important pillar of all, your social life. Some intelligent folks will say that they are fine being alone by themselves. And they are correct. They have built an entire life and identity around the fact that they can live without the presence of another human soul. But it is most likely cope. The word cope gets a bad rep usually. So I want to hijack the meaning a little before we continue further. If I now use the word cope or coping mechanism, you've already heard this term a million times. If I don't give proper context, it will just not register inside your mind the proper way. So here we go. Coping is the optimization mechanism of life. Your mind finds a way to cope in order to make any kind of lifestyle beneficial to you in some way. You cope because something inside of you is so out of whack that you have to overcompensate with something else. It's part of the beautiful, parsimonious nature of the universe. As an intelligent person, you build your identity around the complex set of ideas that you are obsessed with and that set you apart from others. Some of these ideas are a reactionary response to something that previously happened in your life. This can be a defect of nature or nurture. You go all in on a skill to outshine all the other things you are not good at in your life. And you stiffen that identity into hard fucking stone. Because that's the only way you know how to optimize your life. That's your only cope. And this, my friend, is the moment you start alienating yourself from other people, while still carrying that brain of yours around like a trophy. I got the idea for this talk from a distinguished gentleman that likes to comment a lot on my videos. And in a response, I mentioned how the most important skill smart folks have to learn is to tone down the deep talk and actually enjoy it. What I find is that when you are an observant yet non-judgmental person, the entire world opens up to you in unexpected ways. Every boring interaction becomes an opportunity to understand the world more. It's a hell of a drug to be addicted to. In the little annoyances, you find opportunities to understand human nature in ways you did not think possible before. There is beauty even in the dumb speak. You can become fascinated with it, the same way you are fascinated with deep conversation. Dumb talk and small talk show you human nature as it is. You logical motherfuckers will have a blast once you find out that there's a completely new realm out there to spark up your brain with. And guess what? It has nothing to do with logic. It has everything to do with complete and utter irrationality. Imagine becoming a wizard at surfing the irrational. Bonkers! While others are trying to move through reality comfortably by fitting it into a neat logical system, you are able to do without. Ain't that a lot of fun? Back in high school, I used to be that little dipshit that hates small talk and thinks of everybody else as illogical. Because I saw reality through a small lens, and that didn't allow me to relate to most. But what if I told you that you can live life without attachment to your narrow lens? When you start seeing this for yourself, the world becomes your playground. So go play. And as always, cheers for watching.